raw form of meteorite, what do you do to it? I'm going to grind it and polish it. So like if I want to grind certain areas and bring it up, just kind of create it, maybe like a jewelry design. I have no idea what I'm doing. Create my own little spots on it. Look at that. So you can shape it. Put your own little designs on it. Go, you can grind it all the way down if you want, depending on what you want to do. Okay, and then from here, yeah, pretty, and feel it, it's not even hot.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
So,
how much is one of these
things? It starts at $489.
How much?
$489, and it's on sale for $465 now.
$489?
So, yes, and it's on sale for $485. So like, look how, did you see how those scratches are eliminated?
And does it come with all the
kit? Everything I'm going to do right now is what comes in the kit. So do you see that scratch? And so you hold it right here, and you can see them just disappear. So a lot of the handwork is eliminated. You can just touch it up. I'll just do it really quick. And what this does is it blends the metal, so it really seals off. Oh yeah, no, I can touch it. I could touch it. I just don't want dirty fingers.
Yeah.
And so from here, I will just go to my felt polishing wheel. And just use my Jooltool compound. And just polish. And it polishes, I swear, it looks like argentium, it looks like platinum. You see that? And then here too. I'm gonna do it right now. It's like a blue look to it. It's not. Okay, so here. Look at the colors that you get. Isn't that crazy? Like this is all the reflection. And then from that to like the cool piece of jewelry. So polish a meteorite in two steps. Three steps.
Field trips.
Grind and polish.
I think you do a polish.
Sure. Well, hold on. Give me 1 second. I want to try what he wanted to do, and then I'll do yours. So what am I doing with
these? You put it down.
Oh, I put it here, yes. Okay, so what are we wanting to see? We want to see...
We need to polish the surface of the whole thing, if it can be done on your machine, because it's so
hard. Okay. Yeah, well, right now, like, you can get this all even. So, like, right now, we're just going to kind of fix this argentium piece and all the rough edges, clean up, make yourself look a little crisper. It looks just like you cut it with a scissor. And so make yourself a little crisper. So that really quick. Don't have to use a hand file. Didn't have to use a Fordham. You know, some of this stuff too, I'll tell you. No, I think it'll maintain its structure. Okay, see how it's cutting? So we'll bring this up. See, had you prepped this before you soldered it or fused it.
Wandered. So it coated it?
Yes, I know, but I'm saying like the edges of your piece.
Oh.
Had you polished it before?
No, no. Not the edges.
Yeah. Yeah. There. I want to get as close in there as possible. I'll tell you that.
It's not
it got very hard. Whatever you did to it became very hard. The meteorite. Whatever you did to it, I have no idea. But it got hard.
We certainly heated it.
Yeah. So from here, we cleaned up the meteorite. And then I'll clean it with the Scotch-Brite unitized wheel. brush off the rough scratches and gives a nice smooth finish.
What grit are you
on? It's a 3S fine unitized material by 3M. So this will blend the metal instead of grinding it off like sandpaper. So it's very forgiving. However, there's a really deep, deep. Without grinding any kind of material, so we'll just kind of blend that corner a little bit. And there she do. So clean that up pretty much. Really nice. And you can do the sides here if you wanted to. But I just want to concentrate mainly with the argentium. And that just cleans up argentium. But you've got a lot of flux on here. Did you put this in the pickle at all?
No, not this last time.
Yeah, it needs a little pickling. It won't take it off. The flux is too baked on. But no worries, watch how we'll polish.
This is from the plate.
So much easier with two hands than, you know, working with a buffer. You know, this is hard to do. You'll be on your flex shaft in your buffer for a long time to do what I'm just doing in a few minutes. Can you see that? Get in there. And so we already did that side. Nice and polished. And we'll do the... Just finish up the tip. So if you notice, it just took us a few minutes. Whereas if you had used sandpaper, like I said, a Dremel or a flex shaft, this would not be as easy as I made it look. And I had full control with both of my hands. And there you go. Take a look at the finish. This is a meteorite. Oh my god, it looks so ridiculously gorgeous.
Yeah,
we've been
doing that. Making $1,000 I had to go through.
Yeah, what do you think? Did you expect it? I'll wipe it down, but did you expect it to look like that?
Well, that's how it would look if I hit it up final with cerium.
Yeah, but we have cerium. For example, 3M makes cerium. But you would not have... Cerium, to get to cerium, you have to have grinded and prepped the surface.
Yeah, which I would have done on my flat lap.
Flat lap.
Yeah.
But how would you get...
No,
how this, would you get into all these...
I was
going
to probably have to use these.
Okay, and I'll tell you right now, if you use those... you would have a very porous surface, because these are great for getting into a hard to reach area, but to do a large surface like this, you would never get this finish. Unfortunately, those brushes just have only one purpose, and one purpose only is getting into a hard to reach area. And I would have done that around the edges, and we would have been good.
Yeah, that's all I would have done. And then use probably a charged felt wheel, hard felt, to do what you just did, because I don't have your tool.
Right, but you'd have to prep it before. Do
you know how? Sure.
Yes, now you need my tool, but I used actually a 120 grit ceramic, which was the Cubitron 2. I used the 3M unitized Scotch-Brite wheel in the fine, and then I followed with my felt wheel and my jewelry compound. So I did three steps because the surface was so rough, I had no choice but to use the 120 grit to grind it. Yeah, it was so lumpy and bumpy.
Yeah, but it came out great.
I love the design. It's so cool.